Yeah, my name is Manfred Nowak from the University of Vienna, and the Ludwig Boltzmann Institute of Human Rights is also one of the partners in the FRAME project. We are now in Bosnia at the Work Package 5 workshop, which is dealing with the role of the United Nations, of the European Union in relation to the human rights policies in the United Nations, but also in regional organizations such as the Council of Europe or the Organization for Security and Cooperation in Europe, but also outside of Europe, Organization of American States and others. So far it's a fascinating workshop because it's always introduced by research that has been carried out in the framework of this one work package by researchers here at the University in Bosnia and the Bosnian Human Rights Center. And then we have panels with practitioners, persons working in the Office of the High Commissioner for Human Rights in Geneva, coordinating the Human Rights Council, those coordinating the EU Impact COHOM, others from the civil society, Amnesty International, FIDH, etc. Many of those research conclusions are highly critical of the European Union. For instance, saying there is not enough coherence, there is double standards between internal and external policies, civil and political rights play a very important role, but economic, social and cultural rights have been neglected, there is not enough done on new initiatives for new treaties on transnational corporations, on older persons and others. And then to see what are the realpolitik challenges for the European Union, also member states. We just heard about what the United Kingdom has to do in order to please its bilateral relationships with the United States, with China on the other hand, and that also has of course an impact on how the EU and the UK are acting within the Human Rights Council or in the broader picture. So we are also talking about the Security Council, the General Assembly of the United Nations. So it is, I think, a very important step in the overall FRAME project. I hand now over to Chide Kenja, who is the one who primarily organized this workshop in Poznan.
The workshop is, in fact, sort of a point of the on the road to the recommendations which, in the framework of the project, should be elaborated on and then handed over to the responsible authorities of the European Union. There is a lot of expectations vis-à-vis the European Union policies in the area of human rights at the UN and also with regard to the regional organizations. And we have carried out in the framework of our research team a number of interviews with different actors from academia, from the diplomatic world, from the world of the international organizations. And we have, in fact, got a very, in a way, optimistic message on the one hand, that in particular after the Lisbon Treaty, the European Union is developing towards not only one of the major actors in the field of human rights, but also an actor who is ready to assume a responsibility in various areas of human rights in the global dimension. However, at the same time, from these interviews, we also can gather that there is a lot of frustration that somewhat the already mentioned limited coherence between external and internal action in the European Union. I would say unused opportunities at the level of the United Nations. That these issues, these challenges can be addressed even more effectively. One can wonder how it happens that there are this sort of different views, that there are some frustrations also related to the question of some not particularly appreciated choices of priorities of the European Union, or lack of some priorities. How it happens that the EU is not, in fact, acting in a way which will be fully commensurate with its potential as a global human rights champion. It seems, and it can be also gathered from this discussion, that that one of the reasons for that is certainly the ongoing policy discussion within the EU, which has not been concluded yet to the extent that it would be possible to move deliberately further, although enormous progress has been achieved with the adoption of the new strategy framework and action plan of the European Union in the area of human rights and democratization. But there is a sort of a clash between the, let's say, aspiration of the European Union, the policy development, and the capacities to do the job. And I believe that during this workshop, we will have a lot of opportunities still to go more in a detailed way in many of these aspects of the work of the European Union, so that we can, at the end of our meeting, be able to articulate some ideas, proposals for the Union, for the member states, concerning the approach to human rights at the United Nations and with regard to regional organizations.